Let's open our heart to the living God tonight. See, God gives grace to the humble. And God resists the proud and the haughty. So let us humble with our circumstances before God. As we place our dependence on Him and not in ourselves. So when we begin to pray, we pray for the things that's impossible with us. But when we humble to God, all things become possible. When King Jehoshaphat was facing a crisis in his life, there was something that was happening that was beyond his control. Just like tonight, there may be things that you're facing that's beyond your control. It may look like you're at the bottom of the barrel. You look like you're at the end of yourself. Instead of trying to wrestle with the situation in your own ability, even if you face crisis and sickness and diseases, areas where you're weak at in your mind, so when we humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God, He's going to lift you up. The poor cry and the Lord hears them and delivers them out of all their troubles. So let's humble ourselves to Jesus. Let's just open our heart to the living God. Let's worship the Lord. Let's lay down our carnal mind and our thoughts and all our burdens and things that we carry in our heart. The things that we're concerned for, God, we are turning to You with all of our hearts.
You're struggling in the midst of your crisis.
And you know that your circumstances have put you in great bondage. And therefore you turn to God as you humble and say, God, hear my prayer this night. Hear my cry as I cry to you with all of my heart. As we begin to humble and admit that how we need to depend on you to intervene in all of our situations. And then we begin to put our faith in the living God says, Father, you are my Father, you are my God, and you have power over all the power of this world, so that there is no one that can stand against you. And we are not yielding to your strength and your power so we can stand against the circumstances that we're facing. And we're calling upon your holy name right now as we begin to pray on behalf of our nation, as we begin to pray on behalf of our loved ones, and we begin to pray on behalf of ourselves. And we ask you, God, to say, God, look what's happening to your life right now. Look how the enemy has come against us. He's coming out to kill, to destroy, to steal, and even to lie. But we come to you this night in humbling, God, because we're declaring tonight as we're humbling to you that in our own mind we have no might, no power. But we're not putting our faith in what we can do. We are putting our faith in what you can do. Oh, that you will open the heavens. Release the glory of God. Listen to the glorious presence of the living God. We humble ourselves.
We sanctify ourselves.
ourselves as we yield to you this night. And we automatically are not going to let nobody put up offenses in our heart towards anybody. So we lay those circumstances down to the grace of God. And we give to you right now. We commit these things into your hands so our heart can maintain pure and holy, because now we're yielding to the grace and power of the living God. We are submitting ourselves to the authority of Jesus. And now by the authority and the power of God, God, look how the enemy has come against us, oh God. And we have no might and power that there's anything we can do. But now we yield to your strength and to your holy power. And we believe you're going to intervene in our situation, no matter what it is. And you're going to lift us up. And now, God, look how the enemy has come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Look how the enemy is trying to devour us through the circumstances. Therefore, we call upon your name and humble and place our total trust and faith in you, that you're going to intervene even this night by the power of the Spirit. And you will intervene even those who are in the midst of crisis. And God, you send a refreshing of your presence and the power of your Holy Ghost that come and waken your people up in the name of Jesus. Holy Father, let your word go forth in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And right now, God, you're going to come against the enemy that has come against us. You're going to raise up your holy angels, and you're going to go before us, and you're going to fight over our circumstances. You're going to go before us, and you're going to triumph over everything that they have come against us. And those that are doing things to harm us and to hurt us, that's trying to steal from us, that's trying to kill us spiritually, we now take a stand against that spirit, and we bind it in the name of Jesus. We bind the thief, for we catch the thief. And right now, by the power of God, you're going to manifest in the mighty name of Jesus. You're going to do something supernatural. God, you can transfer the circumstances and the things that the enemy has stolen. You can now open the heavens and provide and bring supplies, and open the heavens that you may open up our hearts and minds to yield to the glory of God, to have a pureness in our hearts like Jesus has when he laid down his life and died for us, and through his death and through the sacrifice of himself, being so holy and righteous, he had the power to prevail against darkness. He had the power to deliver us. He had the power to break every yoke and bondage. He had the power to loose us from the captivity of our circumstances. And he began to declare at the cross as he was giving up his last breath, saying, "It's finished. It's finished now. What the enemy intended for evil, I'm going to turn it for glory. I'm going to heal you. I'm going to deliver you. I'm going to set you free. I'm going to bless you. I'm going to prosper you." In a way that you could never imagine. I will open up the heavens and pour out the Spirit. I will release the glory and the power of God in the mighty name of Jesus. And you will go forth now you release your glorious power. We now yield to the Holy Ghost. We yield to your authority and your power. We yield to the authority of God. For you declare, as we go before us this very hour, in every situation, you're coming against every sickness and you're coming against every power of the enemy. You raise up the standard of your anointing, hallelujah. And right now, release the power of the living God. For the battle is not yours. The battle is not yours. So we yield to your power. We yield to your life and to your love, hallelujah. We yield to the forgiveness of your power, and we forgive those who trespass against us. So you can set us free. And it's a righteous thing for you now, God, to recompense. Tribulation of them that trouble you, it's a righteous thing for you to bring justice into this land and bring a judgment to them that break the law. You have a justice and righteous thing to catch those that are doing evil and wickedness and put a stop to their evilness and let them be caught. Because we're now trusting that you have the power to deliver us and to captivate the enemy who's come against us. And God, you're going to command your blessing upon us. You're going to command your outpouring of your Spirit to come and fill us, oh God. God, that you will release your fire and your glory. Holy Father, now, Father, restore to us now our health. Restore to us your Spirit. Restore to us everything that the enemy has stolen. Restore to us everything, very personal. Because we ask this in Jesus' name, and it's your will to restore to us. It's your will for us to prosper, to be in health, even as our soul prosper. It is your will that we come into the knowledge and the will of Jesus Christ, to the full maturity in yielding ourselves to the Holy Spirit. It is your will, Father, for us to be filled with the Holy Ghost and the fire of God, hallelujah. Because we're yielding to you right now and emptying our heart from every imagination of God. And we lay it all before you, and as we say, we declare right now that God, go before us and fight our battles and bring justice in the name of Jesus and restoration. Blessing and abundance. Hallelujah. Oda Masifa Maria Masaya Namasaya. Those that are doing things wickedly, and those that are doing things secretly, those who have done things that they think they have gotten away with it. Now, God, you catch them in their very acts. You will catch them, and you will cause them to be caught and bring them to judgment. And you're going to put a stop to their evil wickedness, that they will no longer do this evilness towards anybody. And you'll bring protection and healing to your people, moving by the power of the living God. Hallelujah. Holy Father.
Let's wash our hearts, wash our minds.
that we can yield to your Spirit. Purify our minds and fill us with your glory. Fill us with your light that we can walk in your truth and righteousness. Wash and cleanse the heart that a heart may become pure and holy and righteous. As we acknowledge God in ourselves that we are spiritually poor, therefore we will press into your glory and enter into your kingdom. For theirs is the kingdom of God, who acknowledges the areas in their life that they're poor. How much we need to depend on you this time, hallelujah. Blessed are those who mourn tonight. Every one of you that are mourning this night, hallelujah, over the condition of your mind and your thoughts. Humbling yourself and mourning over what's taking place in your life. And you begin to yield to God and say, God, have mercy on me. Come and deliver us this very hour according to the grace of God. Release your holiness and open the blessings and bring peace and comfort, for they that are merciful shall receive mercy. And we're asking like the blind man asking, Lord, have mercy on me. And the Lord in his mercy giving to this man that was blind, that this man begin to see. As we begin to have mercy on those who trespass against us, and have forgiveness for those who done us wrong, then you will also forgive us, O God. You will have mercy on us as well as you have mercy on others. And we pray now, God, that you intervene now. And now, God, we give ourselves to you, O God. And you will deliver us this very day by the grace and mercy of God. Oh God, as we humble, as we sanctify ourselves to the offering of the blood of Jesus, as we are sanctified by the power of your Spirit, take on the very nature of Christ to walk in your truth and righteousness. And God, right now, we thank you, God. Vengeance is yours and not ours. For we will keep our heart pure and clean, and we will not defile us by the circumstances, nor will we allow frustration or anger to come into our hearts when somebody has done us wrong. Instead, we're going to stand in the gap and pray on their behalf that they may be saved from the evil and wickedness of their mind and life. And God, that you will bring conviction upon it that they did not enjoy their pleasure of sin for a season. They will not be satisfied till they turn to God. Hallelujah. Hold on a Messiah, on a Messiah. We bind every principality and power, every spiritual wickedness in high places, hallelujah. We stand in the gap and make up the heads that men may be delivered from the corruption of this world and turn to righteousness, O God. Release your divine favor upon us, and everything we place our hand will be blessed, O God. But it will be blessed with a clean conscience. It will be blessed because we will do the right thing, O God. Hallelujah, we will reign in righteousness, hallelujah. Thank you. as you will expose those who are walking in darkness, those who are doing things contrary to the Word of God, those that are stealing, those who are lying, those who are misleading people and deceiving them. And God, if you will now catch them and their very act of their evilness, and let them be exposed, that you will anoint those in authority that will find them and find out the very method and how they did it, and improving what they have done, and they will be found guilty of the crime they have committed. And now, God, let it be caught. I pray, let it be caught. You cause the situation. You will cause men and women to move in a way that they never dreamed of. And God, you're going to show them and reveal to them how to catch these people that are doing this evilness. And then, God, when they get caught, you bring the judgment according to judgment, according to righteousness. And at the same time, not only going to bring judgment to them, but they shall also bring restoration for everything that they have stolen. And they shall restore the people that they have wronged and stole from. Now, God, I commit these people into your hands, and if there's others that are involved with them, every one of them will be caught by the Spirit of God. Father, that you would make us something like that, Jesus. And God, fill us with your glory and your peace. And your joy and your Holy Ghost. As we yield to your righteousness, O God. Purify our souls in the Holy Ghost. Come, Lord. Come, Lord, and quicken our mortal body. Mortify all of our pains and our hurts and our wounds. Sanctify us, O God. So our conscience and our mind will be so pure that we'll be able to see God in His glory and His righteousness. And that your kingdom can then enter into our hearts. Your kingdom can come alive in our minds. Your kingdom can come alive in our hearts and minds.
There's no need for him to be there.
In the name of Jesus, oh God, open the heavens and release it from this captivity.
By my spirit, and you shall enter into my rest.
You will cease from your works and you start walking in my grace. And I will cause my spirit to flow freely. I shall take away the burdens and the bondages that the enemy has placed you under. I will cause you to break through into my glory. And you will know that I am God. You will know that I am with you and in you. You will know that greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Trust me with all your heart. Yield to my love and my divine manifestation of the holiness. Even this night I will open the heavens and pour out the blessing. There shall not be room enough to receive. I will give you divine favor like you have never seen in your life. Receive my blessings in your spirit, in your mind, in your emotions, through the divine nature of God to take over your soul, your spirit, your body. I will quicken you by my spirit. And I will open the provisions of all the things that you're going to ever need in your life. And you're going to be blessed and highly favored of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, I will trust you. And I will trust you with all of my heart, lean not unto my understanding. Who against hope believes in hope? Who against all hopelessness we rise in faith, believing in the hope that we have in you. And we're not going to stagger at the promise of God this time. We're going to stand strong. We shall not waver, nor shall we doubt. Nor are we going to allow our heart to be troubled or be filled with fear and worry. But we yield to your glorious presence and abide and dwell in your Holy Spirit. And now we become strong in the Lord in the power of his might. We become strong in faith and power, and we are being filled with full confidence and assurance in the Word of God as we yield to your grace and we yield to your mercy. Hallelujah. We become partakers of the divine nature of God and begin to walk in your holiness. Thank you. who forgives us all our sins, heals us from every sickness and disease. Release the blessing of God upon our life now. We believe in you. We trust in you. Now, call those things which be not as though they were. Father, I ask you in Jesus' name, you restore to me everything. Everything. Everything in my life, in every area of my life. You're going to restore to us everything. You shall supply all of our needs according to your riches and glory. Holy Father, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. We will trust you. We will trust in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And give us a greater love for the lost. Give us a greater power and faith to speak life into their lives that they may be delivered and set free by the power. Draw all the people from the north, south, east, and the west. Draw them in by your power, even now. Release your glory, O God. Open the heaven and pour out your spirit. Manifest yourself in the midst of them. Heal the sick, cause the lame to walk and the blind to see. Raise the dead. Raise the people from the deadness of their sins to come into the abundant life of life that is in Jesus Christ. We give you all the glory and praise. We bless the Lord. We bless the Lord, for he is my God. We yield you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. You are my King and my Lord. Grant us your divine favor in everything we put our hands to, and open up our heart in the name of Jesus. Lord and God, we just want to thank you, God. We want to praise you.
Thank you, Lord.
We want to love you. Amen. We want to serve you. Yes. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Thank you, God. Amen. Bless you. Yes. Bless your people.
Thank you.
God, we ask the heathen for our inheritance. We ask the uttermost parts of this earth as our possession. Hallelujah. The earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. And you will reign, you shall rule over all the kingdoms of the world. And you are in charge even now that none is able to stand against you. Therefore we yield to you with all of our hearts. In our heart, spirits, this very day and hour. In Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Anoint the service tomorrow with the fin meeting. Release the utterance. Release the manifestation of your grace. Manifest your love in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.